हाय गाइस, वेलकम टू फिल्मी फिटनेस। दिस इज अमंटिलो एंड टुडे इज द वीक 5 डे 22 ऑफ आवर 10 वीक लीन बॉडी चैलेंज। फर्स्ट आई एम डूइंग 15 मिनट कंपाउंड सेट फंक्शनल सर्किट ट्रेनिंग टू एक्टिवेट ऑल माय मसल्स। आई एम स्टार्टिंग विद पंचिंग बैग एंड बैटल रोप एंड गोइंग टू डू 2 सेट्स। वन ऑफ द फंक्शनल बेनिफिट ऑफ बैटल रोप इज दैट दे बूस्ट योर रेंज ऑफ मोशन। हिटिंग अ पंचिंग बैग हेल्प्स यू टू इम्प्रूव योर स्ट्रेंथ, स्पीड, कोऑर्डिनेशन एंड एंड्यूरेंस एट द सेम टाइम। Along with increased strength and fat loss, battle rope provide an intense cardio workout. And the next compound set is step ups and sledgehammer. As you guys know, last week was my straight set without rest week, and this week I'm going to do compound set. So first of all, let me explain you about compound sets. In compound sets, you perform two different exercises for the same muscle group. For example, if I do sledgehammer, at the same time I do step ups. No rest in between the sets. When you perform a chop movement, you move the sledgehammer in a diagonal manner across your body. Because sledgehammers are heavy, your forearms stay contracted during sledgehammer workout. I just completed my warm up, so let's start with our compound set for chest, 2 core and 2 functional workout. I'm going to do incline bench press and decline push-ups with 3 sets and 20 reps. Incline press mainly focuses on upper portion of pectoral muscles. A decline push-up is an advanced variation of the basic push-up that increases the difficulty by placing your feet higher than your hands. It will help you get the most out of your chest workout. Chest incline press improves upper body strength, better push-up and improved health. If you don't keep your core braced and torso stiff, you will sag and this can lead to back pain. This is an indication that you have not built enough core strength. This exercise may seem to be easy, but it requires concentration to engage upper pectorals during the movement. Don't do these common mistakes are lifting too heavy, incorrect form of elbow, overstretching the chest. Always keep a slight bend in the elbows. And the next compound set is machine chest press, push-ups and dips. I'm going to do 3 sets with 15 reps. The chest press leaves you free to focus on your training. Performing few push-ups with correct form will be better than completing many with poor form. Dips are an exercise which is done using your own body weight, which is best for your upper body. The arms placed under a weight bearing load are pushed away from the chest and returned to the starting position. Place your palms flat on the floor instead of cupping them to avoid straining your hands. As a compound exercise, dips are great for challenging a number of your upper body muscles all at the same time. This exercise is excellent for beginners. It provides an effective straightforward way to work your body. Lock down at the ground during this exercise to avoid straining your neck. Other exercises like bench press, chin-ups and push-ups will see a benefit from a strength and flexibility involved in a performing dips. After 3 sets, taking 1 minute break and sipping up my drink, that is EAA and glutamine. Moving on to the next compound set, that is bench press and pullover. I'm going to do 3 sets with 20 reps. This exercise mainly targets the middle chest. If you are new to the bench press, work with a supporter. The dumbbell pullover is widely used resistance exercise that primarily strengthens the muscle in the chest, large wing shaped muscle in the back, and improve core stability. Bench press can be an effective exercise for building up chest, arm, and shoulder muscles. Make sure you are lifting the correct weight for your fitness level. You can also engage the core muscle and triceps. The dumbbell pullover is one of the few exercises that train both front and back of the body at the same time. Grabbing the bar a little wider than my shoulder width, breathe in as you lower the bar, touch the chest and push up with the leg drive. Keep in mind the proper start position, engage the core and keep the extension of your arms equal, going up and down in full control. After 3 sets, taking 1 minute break and sipping up my drink, that is EAA and glutamine. And the 6th compound set is cable crossovers and incline push-ups. I'm going to do 3 sets with 15 reps. Cable crossovers target major muscle in bottom part of your chest as well as activating muscles in your shoulder and back. Make sure that your body is in straight line while you are in plank position. One common mistake is sitting yourself too close, which can cause your back to arch. Swing the weight slowly and in full control, and not forming an arc but pushing from the shoulder. You perform this exercise on hard surface and away from the object that can slide under you. This can be very beneficial for stimulating hypertrophy, increasing control over the movement and building strength. It also allows to increase strength and muscle size quickly. If you find to keep your body in a straight line, you may do knee push-ups. You will still get a great chest workout as long as you keep your spine long and your core tight. After 1 minute rest, now 2 compound sets of core workout. So let's start with the 7th compound set, that is hanging leg raises and cable crunch. I'm going to do 3 sets with 15 reps. The hanging leg raises is one of the best exercises for developing abdominal and core strength. Also, cable crunches are undoubtedly extremely effective at building and shredding abs. Raising your legs engages all of your abdominal muscles, including the lower abs, making the exercise can better than crunches, which only engages the upper abs. It allows muscle growth that you would not have achieved if you stick to typical ab exercise like sit-ups. The most important part of this exercise are to make sure that you are pre-stretch your abs when hanging and rolling your pelvic under and up as you raise your legs. Just make sure that you don't go overboard with the cable crunches. Perform this move at most twice a week, because your abs need time to recover from it. Moving on to the last compound set, that is decline reverse crunch and oblique crunch hyper bench. I'm going to do 3 sets with 15 reps. The decline angle increase difficulty and provide great ab burnout move. You can target your external oblique muscle ideally, although it's a rather advanced movement, so I don't recommend it for beginners. It can be progressed over time by increasing the decline or adding weight. Pairs well with other ab movements in a circuit. Beginners can do exercise on the floor instead, such as oblique crunch or standing side crunch with light dumbbell. That's all for the day. After workout, don't forget to stretch to avoid soreness and improve flexibility. If this information was helpful, give me thumbs up. See you all tomorrow. It's Filmy Fitness by Aman Tilo and powered by Purely Pictures. Stay tuned, stay safe, and stay fit.